Right, this is a semi-stitched part of the salwar. The seams that I've done is that seam on the inside leg seam. There's no seam here. What I've done is the most important part to this salwar is this pressing, this iron mark, because this is the only way we can tell where the center of this salwar, where we're going to pleat this, is coming. So if I turn this right side over now, you can actually just about visibly see over here where I have actually crease marked this, so that this is the line that I will be following for when I actually do the pleating. So the inside leg of this now is all stitched up. There's no seam on the inside leg, and the only way we can tell where that is going to be, that inside leg is going to be, is by that crease mark that I've actually gone and placed. So if you can figure out how this salwar is formed, is cut at an angle from the above where I've taken away the excess fabric so that it's not so lengthy. To keep the width, that's the whole of the width where the pleating will form to make it into the kujur shape. So it will be like gathers here, gathers there, and this is the length of the salwar, and then it's going to be belted over. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just do a small poncha. I'm actually just going to pipe this, just a small piping at the bottom, because that's the only poncha that is going to be. So I'm going to do that first, and then I'm going to show you how I'm going to pleat this on the inside leg, and then we're going to pleat the belt. Now before we go on to doing this, the only other thing that I've got to cut out is the belt. These were the pieces that I have left over from the side. So I'm just going to cut out the belt for the salwar. These were the two identical pieces that actually came out. So the belt I'm going to cut, it's going to be a length of 22 inches by 9 inches. It's an average belt. 22 inches by 9 inches in height. Now don't make this salwar overly long, because it's heavy, it will tend to drag quite a bit. So that's my belt. Now I've got to decide on what I'm going to do about the turning on my poncha, because I've got to really decide what kind of a kameez I'm going to have on this. Now the kameez that I've actually got, I'll show you in a few minutes, but I think what I'll do is I'll use this bias cut piece. These are the pieces that came from the top of the salwar, and I'm actually going to cut two pieces out of this, and I'm going to pipe the poncha with this. There's not going to be any bukram or anything. I'm going to do the one, and then I'll show you how to do the next one.